will soon, or we already ready our mind that I know what he's going to preach and what he's about to preach about. Somebody say amen. 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 Verse 1 says, Jesus went unto the Mount of Olives, and early in the morning he came again unto the temple, and all the people came unto him, and he sat down and taught them. And the scribes and the Pharisees brought unto him a woman taken in adultery. And when they had set her in the midst, they said unto him, Master, this woman was taken in adultery in the very act. Now Moses, somebody say, now Moses. And the law commanded us that such should be stoned. But what sayest thou? This they said, tempting him, that they might have to accuse him. But Jesus stooped down and with his finger wrote on the ground, as though he heard them not. So when they continued asking him, he lifted up himself. When they continued asking him, he stood up and said unto them, he that is without sin among you, let him cast a stone, let him first cast a stone at her. And again he stooped down and wrote on the ground. And when they which heard it began being convicted by their own conscience, went out one by one, beginning at the eldest, even unto the last, and Jesus was left alone. Listen to this. Jesus was left alone, and the woman standing in the midst. When Jesus had lifted up himself, this is the second time where it says Jesus stood up. When Jesus had stood up and saw none but the woman, he said unto her, woman, where are those thine accusers? Have no man condemned thee? She said, no man, Lord. And Jesus said unto her, neither do I condemn thee. Go and sin no more. And if I can use what time is going to come out of verse 7 and verse 11, it say he lifted up himself. And verse 10, it says it again. When Jesus had lifted up himself, amen, if I can use what title, he stood up for me. He stood up for me. He stood up for me. The word lifted means to raise to a higher position or level. And as I began to read this, the Lord began to show me that all of us that's in here need to know that at one point or another in our life, he stood up for us. He stood up for me. And I heard Minister Gerard talking as he was ministering. And he said, God, you protected me. And anytime somebody stands up for you, they're taking a defense for you. If I was in a place and trouble was about to happen, and it looked like I couldn't handle the trouble, I don't think y'all may know this place, but just so you can see this picture, there was a time when we used to go to this club by the name of Lakeside Paradise. Y'all know what I'm talking about, Lord? And Aaron. And we used to get there and we used to start a party within a party. Somebody say amen. And if they looked over there, or if I looked at them and saw trouble happening, and I would sit down, Sister Geraldine, one of us would automatically stand up. Even though we ain't got nothing to do with it, but because, good God, of the relationship, we would stand up. And once we stood up, we weren't distracted by nobody that was in our way because I got somebody on my mind. And even though Roy or Aaron wasn't saying nothing, or I wasn't saying nothing, whoever was in that faith, they need to know that I come to protect them. I come to speak up for them. I come to defend them. I know you may say have nothing to do with it, but I stood up because of relationship. And the Lord told me to tell you that whatever you're dealing with today, I have stood up for you. Yeah, they may be talking back to the high. You're about to, I come with God to stand up on your behalf. I come to stand up when repossession came, and I come to stand up for you when divorce and curses came for you. I come to stand up for you. I come to stand up for you when sickness was trying to come and get you. I come to stand up for you. When poverty tried to come get you, I tried to get to the text, but God said, tell my people that I'm standing up for them. I come to stand up for them when nobody else won't stand up for them. I come to stand up for them when people are talking about them. I come to stand up for them when people say they'll never amount to anything. I come to God to stand up for them. And God told me to tell some of you, the only reason you're still on the job, the only reason you got your promotion, the only reason you got your increase is because I stood up for you. Yeah, I stood up for you. They were trying to buy you, and you did what they said you did, but I stood up for you. Sometimes, well, we don't know how God's standing up for, but you can look the next day and say, this was nobody but the Lord working on my behalf, because I had the church praying for me. I had people naming and claiming to me that God had worked it out, and we didn't see God go to the job, but I found out that God stood up for me. Yeah, yeah, God said, I'm standing up for you. Now. There's a time, man. Yeah, you see it in the text. When Jesus was that stupid down. But when he stood up, what is something about, when you're in a place and you know you're in trouble, somebody say you're in trouble. And you done got yourself in something that you know you can't win and get out. But all of a sudden, you see somebody standing up for you. Lord have mercy. And I ain't going to tell y'all all our business, but let me tell y'all something. We had some kind of connection when we just felt, Lord have mercy. We just felt that one of us was in trouble. And when we felt that, We get a little radar on, and we begin to look for a silhouette. Y'all know what a silhouette is, don't you? And we begin to try to pick up. Devil Roy, he all right. Devil Aaron, he all right. The other one is over there in trouble. And see what the Lord does, he can recognize you in trouble. Lord, and once we picked up who was in trouble, it seemed like all of us, Lord have mercy, arrived at the same time, and we didn't go to talk to the journey, but we went for action. And I want to tell you that God said, when I stand up for you, I am declaring an action. How do I declare an action? I declare an action with speaking my word on your behalf. I know that they said you should have been dead, should have still been locked up, but when I stand up and I said something, it took an action. It went in process, and things begin to change. You might look out of that trouble you was in. I heard y'all minister, but it's all right. Long as you know that he stood up for me, I would have had more than a look. But I come out of this look just to give you my testimony that he stood up for me. Yeah, how in the world are you living? Why are you living if he stood up? Well, I was in the middle of the fight, and he allowed a few things to happen to me just so I can tell that it was nobody but the Lord on my side. I understand that it was so foolish with the name on it. We had some people tell us that, but God said, I stood up for you.
Yeah.
So here in the text, I believe we almost home now. Here in the text, there's this woman being used. Somebody say being used by the religious leaders to trap Jesus. And once as I read this text, I found out that a lot of time it's not people at us, but it's the enemy at the Lord.
Y'all good? I ain't really want to bother you, but I'm bothered.
You ain't really all that.
Lord have mercy.
The enemy is out to attack the Lord. So what he does is he attacks you to bother with the Lord.
We can't see it.
Sometimes there's people that may bother your kids because they know you're so close to them. And it's not about that itty bitty child leave like. Sometimes the enemy just want to get you on task. And so what he does, he bothers something that's dear to us. And what I got to tell you is that when he does that, we stand.
So here in this text, these religious leaders, if I could just paint the picture before we go.
In John 7:53, it says that they all went home. Same way home. They had a benediction. And Jesus come back to church. Somebody say church. And he comes early to the temple. He begins to sit down and he begins to teach. And all of a sudden, the Pharisees and the scribes bring in a woman. Somebody say a woman. That's a female. Into the church service while he's teaching. And they say that this woman was caught in the very act of adultery. Amen. And I know Jesus knew that it took two. Somebody say it takes two. And it tells me, Roy, that there are some religious people that are always watching me. Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy. You better catch it.
They got close enough, me like, to peek in the window to see that that ain't sin. It takes a nosy person.
Lord have mercy.
Because y'all know we got all kind of blinds up. And some of us that grew up in the project got blinds and a shield. Amen. Amen. But I'm talking about the church folk that was supposed to be home. They got close enough that got together and say, us grown folk. I ain't talking about no babies. We talking about Pharisees and scribes. They got close enough to peek and look long enough.
Lord have mercy.
They got peek and go. But they look long enough.
Lord, no bother.
Stand up. I need y'all three to stand up.
Yeah, we come on. All right.
You peek first. And then you this is what I want you to tell them. You ain't got to do it because we doing it now. Then you tell Aaron, yes it is, that ain't who that is. And then Aaron gonna get his peek. And then Roy gonna get his peek. Because they knew that if we're gonna do something, you got to have at least two or three witnesses. And to have two or three witnesses, it can't say Minister Neblack say he saw it. Neblack saw it. So now Brother Eric in the window, Lord have mercy. And he looking in the window now. And I said, yeah, Pastor Dempsey. That's who it is. Can you see y'all sit back down? Can you see my side, somebody's house? Now we're smarter than that in 2015. We'll just drive by the house or drive by the job to see who they're hanging with. Grow up at the gym, you want to work out, knowing that you ain't calling him to work out, but you done peeked up on something at the gym that you want to witness.
Lord have mercy.
And then Roy know the error of jump these pews and he tell her. He'll call Aaron say, E, I'm gonna work out. And Aaron, his mind, I'm coming to work out with you. So they walk in the building and stand them over there on the dip bar or on the elliptical. Cool, they're working out together. And so all of a sudden, when they peek back and see him, your turn, your turn, you're just sitting.